What's up guys, I'm Theo Joe, and today is another video about cool browser extensions for Google Chrome that you might not know about. Obviously, you probably won't want to install every single one, but hopefully at least some of them will be useful to you. Starting off with number one, we have an extension called Night Shift, which lets you put a warm color overlay over web pages so it's a bit easier on the eyes, particularly at night. This kind of feature is built into Android and iOS and even Windows because blue light is known to disrupt sleep at night, so if you just want it for Chrome, this is an option. You can set it to be used whenever you want or on any schedule, and it has some options for a custom schedule, sunrise to sunset, and manual mode too. You also have the ability to set the specific color for the overlay and the strength of it, so if you want it to be really red, you can have that, or a lighter orange, or you can even make it blue if you want for whatever reason, like maybe you actually want to stay up late, who knows, that might help. All right, next up for number two, this is gonna be one for all of you sports buffs, and it's called 365 Scores, which lets you keep track of live sports scores for any number of teams or leagues you wanna track. Now, I don't follow any sports myself, so I can't really tell you how well this works personally, but it seems to be popular and has good reviews, so it's probably worth checking out. The interface is definitely ugly as hell. It looks like something straight out of 2005, but it seems to have a lot of info, like you can track specific teams and then go to the scores tab, and it will show you games from those teams, or you can choose all teams and it will show you everything in that league and then lets you choose past and future dates. Might come in handy if you follow a lot of sports. All right, moving on. Number three isn't really useful, more just kind of neat, and it's called Custom Cursor, which is just like it sounds. When you click the extension icon, it brings up a big selection of different cursors you can replace yours with in Chrome, from regular looking colored ones to cartoon characters and random icons. If you click more cursors, it will then take you to their website, which has a ton more collections and packs for cursors, and there really are a lot of them. Now, if you're like me, you're probably suspicious of extensions and apps like this, forever traumatized from back in the days of the 2000s where you'd see ads for like hundreds of free smileys that ended up just being spyware. But this extension does actually seem to be legit and somehow completely free with no paid options at all, which is surprising. It also gives you the ability to choose custom cursor image if you want, choose cursor size, and even select some favorites that will rotate through automatically. So some of you might like this. On to number four. This one a lot of you will probably like, and it is Delete All Messages for Facebook. And yep, it does just that. Its only purpose is to allow you to bulk delete conversations and messages on Facebook. It's dead simple. You just open Facebook and there will be an option at the top to delete messages, and you can either make it so it will either delete all your messages or choose specifically which ones. Be aware though, once you do it, there is no way to get them back, which is kind of the point. One major thing to keep in mind though is that according to Facebook, even if you delete the messages on your side, it won't delete them from your friend's inbox. And there's no guarantee that even if you and your friend delete a conversation, that Facebook doesn't keep it stored behind the scenes forever. So the usual advice applies: never post anything on the internet, and especially on Facebook, that you don't want being out there permanently. All right, number five is one I really like, and it's called Picture in Picture Extension, and it's actually made by Google themselves, which is cool. How it works is when you're watching a video on YouTube, you can either press Alt-P for the shortcut or just click the extension icon and it will open a little pop-up box for the video that stays on top so you can navigate around other tabs and keep watching it. You can move the box around and expand it, and there's a button to send it back to the original player. One thing I've noticed though is you need to keep the original tab open, because if you close the tab, the video box will close too. And if you click away to something else in the original tab while the video box is playing, it will freeze or glitch out. Also, the controls on the box are limited to just pause and unpausing, but you can keep using the video player in the original tab to control it even when it's in picture-in-picture mode. But despite the limitations, it works well and smoothly, so I am a fan. We're up to number six, which is the Video Speed Controller with Hotkeys extension, yet another literally named extension. This one allows you to easily control the speed of most videos playing on any website, even if it doesn't have a native speed option in the player. You can increase or decrease playback by 25% increments by either clicking the extension icon or using shift bracket hotkeys. You also have some other options like rewinding by a few seconds, and I find this extension really useful because these days I watch nearly every YouTube video at increased speed, so I'm used to it, and it's a pain on sites that don't allow you to speed up playback. It doesn't work on every single website and video player, unfortunately, but I'd say it works in most cases at least. Okay, number 7 is another useful one called Volume Master. This extension gives you total control over volume levels in Chrome, such as increasing or decreasing volumes of specific tabs, as well as the ability to boost tab volume by up to 600%. Of course, keep in mind, boosting it too far might result in the audio clipping and sounding distorted, but it might be good in situations where a tab's audio is legitimately too quiet. The extension can give you a list of tabs playing audio and then switch directly to them if you want. Keep in mind, Chrome already will show a little icon for tabs playing audio, but if you have a ton of tabs, this might be easier. Also, be aware, if you want to just mute a tab, Chrome has a built-in feature to do that by just right-clicking a tab and then selecting Mute Tab. But this extension is still good if you need more specific control. All right, next up, number 8, we have the extension Print Friendly, which is really useful in some cases when you want to print out a website or save it as a PDF or something. And you probably know that for a lot of websites, when you try to print them, they look totally messed up with weird formatting and useless web elements taking up a ton of space. You definitely know what I mean. What this extension does is lets you remove parts of a website before it gets sent to the printer, so you can remove anything that's messing up the way it looks. After you click the extension icon, it brings up an interface where you just click on elements to remove them, along with other controls such as being able to reduce or increase text size between 70 and 130%, and also reduce image size in 25% increments, or just remove them completely by selecting 0%. Then, once you have it looking the way you want, you can send it to the usual print dialog menu, or save it as a PDF from here, though I think Windows already has a built-in option these days to save as a PDF from the print dialog menu anyway. But this extension isn't perfect, and on certain websites using it actually makes the page look worse, like on Google for example, but on other sites it definitely does help, so it's good to have it just as an option if needed. Alright, coming near the end, we got a couple more, and number 9 is called Super Simple Highlighter. What this does is lets you highlight text with a variety of colors on any website by first selecting text and then right-clicking and using the highlighter option to pick a color. In the options, you have some basic settings like customizing the colors to choose from, the opacity of the highlighter, and whether you want the edges to blur or not. What's also nice is it will store the highlighted text so you can keep them as notes for later, and the next time you visit that same page, it will usually re-highlight the same text. The extension info page does warn that it might have trouble re-highlighting the text if the content of the web page changes, but even in that case, I believe it still should keep all the highlighted text stored in the extension menu. And fun fact, this is the extension I personally use when I make videos talking about tech news on my second channel, TheoJoeTech. You'll usually see when I'm talking about a news article, I'll have some highlighted, and this is what I used. So as a side note, if you didn't know about my second channel, be sure to check that out. I use that for more casual discussions about cool tech news. But anyway, finally on to number 10, we have a fun extension called Netflix Party, which allows you to easily watch shows on Netflix with friends and automatically synchronize everyone. How it works is after you open Netflix and start a show, you click the extension and select Start the Party. Then it gives you a link to give to whoever you want to watch with. You can also select whether or not you want others to be able to control playback or just you. Keep in mind, everyone will have to have the extension installed for this to work, and you'll all have to be logged into Netflix. But what's also neat is it creates a little chat room where anyone can post stuff if you're not already using some other chat program. And here it also tells you when someone skips to different parts so you can keep track of all that. Now, based on the reviews, it seems like some people have trouble with this extension, so it probably isn't perfect, but it does seem to be updated regularly enough, so it seems like it should work in most cases. And if not, you can always do it the old-fashioned way and just do a countdown in your group chat and hope everyone clicks play at the same time. So there you have it. Let me know which of these extensions you like the most, and if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is a cool video I made talking about different versions of Google Chrome, like the beta, developer, and even canary versions. So if you've never heard of that, you can just click on that video right here. But anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.